If I hadn't have started beekeeping, I wouldn't be able to get out and do some of the things I do now.
The difference in my mental health from pre-bees to now is dramatic. I joined the Air Force in 2002. So I went into one of the intelligence fields within the Air Force, and my career progressed over an 18-year period. My role in the Air Force as an air intelligence analyst is a top secret role, and talking about the majority of those functions is highly classified. I was deployed to Afghanistan in 2015. Some of the things that I'd seen in Afghanistan meant that seeing a psychologist was pertinent. One of the main issues with having trauma and other mental health concerns is that your head does just wander off. Without the bees, I definitely would not be where I am today.
I caught sight of him, and he was a single dad at the time, and he was a very capable, handsome, muscly man in uniform. He was totally oblivious for 6 months, never had any idea that I was interested. When Marc got back from Afghanistan, it was quite a traumatic time. He struggled with things that he would not normally have had difficulty with. For a man that I met and for years was totally capable of doing multiple things, and he suddenly was only able to focus on one at a time. And
while I was there, I was unfortunately injured. I injured my ankle and my spine rather significantly. I ended up having a number of surgeries. It was at that point that I realised my career was coming to an end and I was no longer going to be doing the thing that I loved. And my mental health deteriorated significantly at that point.
Dealing with Marc's symptoms of PTSD before the diagnosis was really hard. You're not only coping with something that you don't understand, but with and not with somebody that's totally different to what you knew.
I struggle to go to places where there's lots of people, like shopping centres and things like that. In Afghanistan, there's a lot of crowds. So unfamiliar places, spaces and faces are the things that triggered me the most. And so noticing the bees was when I was on recovery from surgery. I was sitting on the lounge watching television with my leg up post-surgery. You can see the beehive that was my wife's out the window, and I could see the bees coming and going, and I found myself more interested in the beehive than in the television. Eventually I started opening the hive and then going through the hive, and eventually I said, well, I think I'm a beekeeper now. While I was doing that, I was not having the dark thoughts, so it sort of drowned out all the stuff that was creating negativity in my mind.
By looking after my own mental health, I'm also giving them a chance to grow, expand. Some of the time you're spending, you go, what are they doing? And you get stuck looking at them and go, what the hell are you up to? And then you got to try and figure it out, and then you go, oh yeah, it's pretty cool. I'm one of those that sits there and talks to my bees. It's some people, if they're not beekeepers, think it's crazy, but a lot of beekeepers say, hey, we do that. And yeah, I can talk to them and they're not judgmental or anything. Currently retired, and spend most of my days either trying to repair my house or seeking alternative treatments for my PTSD. I first joined the Navy in 1981. Finishing recruit school was, it felt like a major event in my life. You say, hey, I'm in the Navy now. My last deployment was to the Middle East, to the Gulf, just after the Second Gulf War. I was also tasked by the CO to be what would be probably called a morgue attendant. And me and a few senior personnel, we were responsible for keeping people away from the American members that were killed in action. And it wasn't until after, and you sit down and you go, oh God, what was all that? But yeah, it wasn't until a few years ago that it started to affect me, that particular incident. I ran into some issues where I was placed under an extraordinary amount of stress, and unfortunately, it led to a nervous breakdown, and which then led to my attempted suicide, which was when I finally realised, hey, I've got a problem. I bottled a lot of it up because that was how I was brought up, and that was how I got trained. You know, you move on. There's a bigger picture. There's not just you. I originally got involved in beekeeping through the Navy. My rehab consultant got back to me and said, oh, I found a bloke, he's just up the road from you. I made an appointment with Marc and went and saw him, and then he invited me on the next beekeeping course that he ran. And we've gone from there. The bees to me are an essential part of my well-being. If I didn't have them, I'd probably be lost for another out.
Hey Mick, how you doing? Good to see you, buddy. How's your hive going? Good?
Oh yeah, not too bad. Pretty good.
I think the world is made up of real, true symbiotic relationships, and Marc and the bees are a perfect example of that. They help each other. Without the other just doesn't work.
My mental health journey still has a long way to go. I'm not cured, but I definitely am on the road to recovery. Still recovering myself, but I think that I'm at a point now where I'm strong enough to help others in their journey. With mental health issues, it can sometimes mean that getting up in the morning doesn't work for you, or certain triggers might affect your ability to work. But if you can work for yourself and choose what days you get up and do what you do, that is a way forward, and that is a way to put meaning back into your life.